Don't Worry Baby is a, I don't know, it's a, Don't Worry Baby is a song that, just a great butt. It's like, because you love me, everything's going to be swell.
We call that the Beach Brothers song. Yeah. And that's an effort on our part and the Beach Boys. We did a television show with them in Hawaii and had a wonderful time.
Yeah,
they're wonderful people.
Time.
We've known them forever. And, I mean, as far as vocal groups go, hats off to the Beach Boys.
Yes, sir.
You know? Mm-hmm. And so we did a record with them. And yeah. We love it.
Yeah.
Almost, yeah.
Brian always writes a great song.
Yeah, it's a beautiful song. Some Hearts is about everybody. It's about the hearts. You know, people have broken hearts, got hearts that are mending, hearts that are... It's about love. You say, my heart's broke. That's a love song, a romantic notion. It's also kind of tragic.
Some hearts will die. Some hearts just live. But some
Be My Love Again is a phrase that I've, I wouldn't say I never used it. I've used it quite a few times, actually, but usually in a begging position, and it's pretty much that's what it is.
Truthfully, the old song, Be My Love, the old, Be My Love, yeah. And I wanted us to sing something like that, so somehow I come up with the Be My Love Again, you know?
But it's not close enough for a lawsuit.
No. it's the same words, but it's not the same thing.
It was inspired by opera.
Inspired by opera, yes. Something that you would hear at an Italian restaurant.
It was inspired by the oranges we had at the Italian restaurant after we'd seen the opera, or we'd almost seen the opera.
Maria Lanza records, always one of my favorites.
It's the Everly Brothers.
It's like the full voice treatment of it. It's the full voice treatment of the Everly Brothers singing at the top of their lungs.
That's true.
The lineup is Albert Lee on guitar, Mitch Humphries on keyboards, Phil Cranham on bass, of course Larry London on drums, and Buddy Emmons on the steel guitar, which we're really looking forward to working. We've worked a few dates already, and it's really was nice. So we're looking forward to this tour, and these musicians.
We always think we have the best band in the world.
I didn't follow, but I didn't stay. My heart went with her. But love goes up in flames, trees in a moon.
There seems to have been a life, a special kind of life to this album. Things just sort of happened in the way we had trouble getting the first studio that we had booked down in Florida. And we said, canceled out, and we started looking. It happened on this New River studio, which was almost perfect. And we met Ted Stein, an engineer, and we just all, you know, formed a family and just lucked on out. And things have just kind of rolled like that. And so I'm very great expectations in this. Theory, like you can take a boy out of the country, you can take us out of the Everly Brothers, but you know, if you put us with anything, we always sound like we sound. I also think too the fact that we wrote the majority of the album, it's just like if you'd made your own suit, you know, which I wouldn't do.
we've also kept the people around us, like Larry London, yeah. Ted, at the beginning of the album, that were there. The concept, the beginning, and keep that sound. The people that know our voices are familiar with what we're doing instead of bringing in, sometimes translating what you're doing on the road, going in the studio and forgetting all that other experience and just going on somebody who hasn't been around you. Father, of course, he called himself a country musician, and he taught us, and we grew up in it. We were on the Grand Ole Opry for, what, 2 years? As regulars. We never really have left the country. We moved to California, you know, which seemed out of sight, out of mind sometimes, you know. But our albums and records always have that country flavor, I think, to them, whatever we do. Yeah. Bill's got the least.
The whole, we grew up on country radio, you know, early morning shows. Our whole heritage, our whole background is based on that. It just so happened that Don and I were part and parcel of the people that became rock and roll, you know, what were called rock and roll. And I've always contended to this day that Buddy Holly, Elvis Presley, Jimmy Bourne, and Buddy Knox, and Don and I, and all of us, we were country singers that just never were registered in there. Don and I were one of the few rockers that got on the Grand Ole Opry, but I believe if you played a guitar and sang and you were from the South, the country. They were calling this the Some Hearts Tour, so we'll be doing Some Hearts and about three or four things. In fact, we're putting quite a few of the new album in the show. But we're going to try to do some more specialized kind of things, too.
We've already tried out some of it, and it's worked, and so we're happy with it. And we're going to do some of the new stuff. It seems to work really well. Well, of course, we're touring the United States and Canada, a bit of Canada. We're touring Belgium, Holland, and
Germany.
And we probably will stop off in England, but I don't think we're really doing a tour in England. It's maybe a television, maybe.
I'm very proud of the people that during some of the dry periods that one has gone, bound to go through on a, well, 31-year, that they stayed as a solid base, and they were almost, would be angry that, you know, you weren't getting the proper amount of attention on the radio during the periods. And I think that since our resurgence, it's sort of verified their taste and it's made them very proud that they hung to it. And so I'm very proud of them.